throughout our history. Your faithfulness is walking beside me. Winter storms give way to spring. Amen. From every season, from where I see.
Listen, I was telling John Marlow this morning, there's answered prayers all over the room coming through the door this morning, and it is time to give God praise. If you know that He's still on the throne, that He's still answering prayers. Amen. Father, we just thank You for who You are.
Oh.
be seated. Praise the Lord.
I have something I want to say.
There it is.
Pastor had sent out a little message this weekend that he's going to be talking about Joseph today. And not to even impede upon his sermon, I have no idea, really where he's going with it. But as I was listening and preparation for this song this morning, the song You Say, I got to thinking about the words of the song and about Joseph. If ever there was a man ever to have the feeling and the burden of feeling like he was nothing,
amen,
that he was not meant for anything good, that he was depressed and voices in his head that kept telling him, Joseph, you are nothing. You will always be in this ditch. You will always be in this pit. You will always be in this dungeon.
Yeah.
You have no purpose. If he had listened to that, where would we be?
Come on,
and not just Joseph, but Moses.
Amen.
If Moses had listened, even though he started out in Pharaoh's house, he ended up on the backside of the desert, unbelieving,
yes,
not believing in himself, even when the voice of God spoke to him,
yes,
and told him to take his shoes off because he was on holy ground, he still, God, I am not worthy. I cannot do what you've called me to do. And God said, yes, you can. And we look and we see Rahab in the New Testament. And Rahab was a harlot, not in the New Testament, the Old Testament. Rahab was a harlot, but yet she ended up in the lineage of Christ.
That's right.
Because she was obedient.
That's right.
And we look at Esther, who was just a little Israelite woman, who had no idea that she would ever be used of God. And when she was put in a position, she said, was put in this place.
Yeah.
And we look further and further into the annals of time, and God brought us to where we are. But you know what? And even the disciples, God called the common people.
That's right.
He called the common people and people that nobody else liked.
Amen.
When he took Matthew was not on anybody's guest list because he was not that person. And everybody that he called, you know what the common factor was? Obedience.
There it is.
And what God has said to me, and I want to relate to you, and then we're going to sing this song, is if you bring the effort, the obedience, God is going to bring in the extra.
Amen.
Because it's his gift to give.
That's
and
right.
When you feel that you have no power within yourself to do anything, right, because we have no power, but we have a God who gives us power. And
come on, church, amen.
Brought deliverance through the blood of Jesus. When he died on the cross, he did it for you.
That's right.
He looked beyond what he could see right there. He was human and did not want to go to that cross, but he said, nevertheless, what your will, God, is what I want. And he got on that cross and he endured the pain and the suffering. But you know what? He didn't stop there. If he had, we would have no hope.
That's right.
But he didn't stop there. He went to the cross. He died. But then he went to hell and got the keys and delivered us from death, hell, and the grave. And rose again on the third day to prepare for us, you and me, a place that we have hope beyond this life.
That's right.
To go and meet in his heavenly kingdom. So whatever God says, that's what you can bank on.
Amen and amen. Praise the Lord.